A reunited Germany celebrates in its intimate circle. It celebrates in white.
It's not only the individual women that get voice in my film, but we're also giving voice to a generation of black women who are never allowed to speak.
You're black. You're all the same. We're always put in this box.
Ja, das ist eine große Frage. Was bedeutet das Schwarze denn in Deutschland?
First question actually is, as an English speaker, I've heard and seen both Afro-German and Black German used. Are both acceptable or is one better than the other?
Both terms were coined in the 1980s, so they actually meant the same thing. But I think in the course of time, that's changed a lot. Afro-German is more used by Black Germans who have one white German parent.
I started using Black German almost exclusively. The term Black German, I believe, is seen as more all-encompassing.
Ich bin Fachreferent für Dekolonisierung und Antirassismusarbeit und diese Stelle ist bei der ISD, Initiative Schwarze Menschen, in Deutschland angesiedelt. Ausgangspunkt für die Gründung der ISD war Farbe bekennen.
Farbe bekennen. Showing our colors, it's called in English.
In dem Buch haben schwarze Frauen zum ersten Mal in jüngerer Zeit, jüngerer Vergangenheit, einen Blick geworfen aus der Perspektive von schwarzen Menschen auf die deutsche Geschichte, auf deutsche Verhältnisse, gesellschaftliche Verhältnisse. Und das anhand eigener biografischer Erfahrungen.
I come here to read my poetry tonight as a black feminist, lesbian.
Lord was this amazing Caribbean American feminist who came to teach at the Free University for a summer semester. She taught a couple of courses, literature courses, and it's through those courses that like women such as Maya Eam and Catherine Oventoya met. She sort of encouraged them to write.
Ihre Initiative war, uns zu vermitteln.
She was actually one of the founders of the Black German movement. They coined these terms, her and Katharina and Audre Lorde.
Ich werde trotzdem afrikanisch sein, auch wenn ihr mich gerne deutsch haben wollt.
Why she became so important for me is because she actually gave me a name. She gave me the name Black German.
Oh my God, there's so many things I love about natural hair. So many different textures and so many things we don't know about the way natural hair actually works. To me, nappy headed should really represent the fact that blackness, you can't make it a box. White people have the privilege of not being a homogenic group. But I feel like when it comes to black people, we don't give us the benefit of just being a nerd maybe, or of maybe not being a dancer, or maybe not being a singer, or just being introverted and quiet.
Black in Tech Berlin came about 2 years ago, and I've started it because being in talent acquisition, I'm mostly involved in hiring people into positions in tech companies. If you're black and you're an engineer, there's a lot of opportunities. The not so good side is that when you think about a tech company, there are many departments: it's marketing, business development, design, sales, and these are the departments that actually find it harder to hire black people. What we really want to build is a space or platform that connects black professionals to one another, mentor the next generation, find out what resources are there, so basically build people up.
In Germany, we don't have black studies. We also don't have African history or colonial history. In school books, it's not taught, and it's maximum a side course at university.
There's so few black German academics in Germany, and this is because of the structure. Like, it's very hard to get your PhD and then to get a job. It's like such a huge hurdle, especially if you're a black person. And people don't understand or respect your research.
Why I entered the arts was because the work that I do concerning Black German history or the history of racism in Germany doesn't have a place in academia. I never wanted to make a film. I never planned to make a film.
Wer war Millie? Wie hat sie gelebt? Wie ist sie ins Atelier von Ernst Ludwig Kirchner gekommen?
Ernst Ludwig Kirchner was well known, highly respected artist in mainstream society. So this is also why I woke attention in the mainstream, because I was like, what is she doing without Ernst Ludwig Kirchner? And I was like, this whole thing doesn't even have to do with Ernst Ludwig Kirchner. I'm looking at Millie. The sad part of the story is that there's been so much work done on Ernst Ludwig Kirchner, and there has hardly been any work on the black models of Kirchner. So this is another gap that I'm filling in what I'm doing.
Zum Beispiel Anton Wilhelm Amo, der erste bekannte schwarze Philosoph in Deutschland, der hier studiert und gelehrt hat und der damals in seiner Zeit, 18. Jahrhundert, schon sozusagen auf rassistische Verhältnisse hingewiesen hat und auch ganz klar sozusagen Position bezogen hat in Diskursen, die wir heute Antirassismusarbeit nennen würden.
Hans-Jürgen Massakoy was very influential for me. I read his autobiography, Destined to Witness, when I was still in college.
Olivia Wenzel, who published her first novel last year. Philip Cabell-Copsell, he's also published poetry volumes and prose on Black German history.
This novel is about Black people in Berlin at the turn of the millennium. In the story, there is a character who, when she faints, continues in her subconscious and is going into images of colonial history, of the history of slavery. And then it's trauma, and she has to go through it to come back into this real world. My name is Michael Götting. I'm an author and I'm head of library at Each One Teach One.
In 2014, Each One Teach One Yoto opened its doors as a small black community library. But then we are also looking at really effect on a political scale, having consultations with government agencies and the chancellor around issues of right-wingism and extremism and racism. Yeah, we're pushing on to make sure that, well, hopefully one day we're going to live in a just society.